एम हर्षित रवैया. आई स्टडीड माई एमबीबीएस इन दाओ मेडिकल स्कूल फाउंडेशन एंड आई स्कोर्ड 217 इन एफएमजी जून 2021.
Congratulations, Harshit, on an excellent score. So, how do you feel now?
It's a great experience, and it's an honor to get interviewed by such a great doctor. Thank you, doc.
Okay, great, great, great. Harshit, my first question to you for today, as a matter of fact, because we are going to be, this is going to be listened by your juniors as well. So, when did you
Yes,
actually
doc.
start preparing for the FMG exam per se? Because I understand you have university exams as well, and the schedule is pretty hectic
Yes.
back in Philippines in Davao. I heard they grill you a lot. So, I mean, how do you cope up with both of these?
Actually, I started my preparation back in lockdown when the lockdown was started. But
Okay.
I used to do small topics day by day. I was preparing, not sure about the FMG, but I was preparing daily, building concepts. And I bought the prep ladder in December, and I started my preparation in January. And I made my schedule from prep ladder only. To how to go with the subjects.
Okay, great. So, which were the subjects that you were focusing more on?
I started with the PSN, that's the major chunk in the FMG,
FMG exam.
and OB-GYN, surgery, then pathology, pharmacology, and microbiology, anatomy. These are the subjects which I was more focusing on.
Okay. So, Doc, I hear people having these biased opinions about paper one versus paper two. So, what's your take on this paper? I mean, easy, moderate. I mean, how did you feel after giving the paper individually for both part one and part two?
When I was I was going for the exam, I was pretty anxious about the exam. But when I gave the paper one, I was a little confident that it was easy because pathology and pharmacology, PSM, all the questions were from the prep ladder app only. And in prep paper two, the major questions were from ENT, ophthalmology, and surgery and OB-GYN. And all the questions already included in the question bank. So the question bank is really helpful to me.
Okay, great, great. So, were you giving mock tests also?
Yes, doc. I used to give every month, there was two mock tests, one for the starting of the month and one in the end of the month. So I gave the first mock test, and after getting the result, in the start, I used to get only 133, 125, or 145 or something. But after my preparation build up, I used to get 175 and like passing marks. So
Okay.
the grant test is really a preparation booster.
Great, great, great. And like 1 month before the exam, did you use any special part? Did you revise the main notes? Did you go for rapid revision? I mean, what was your main focus in the last 1 month before the exam?
During last month, my main focus on the revising as much as possible from the main notes, which I already studied in the main app. Because and I did many yours in medicine only. I did the rapid revision in last few days. Surgery rapid revision was really helpful. So the rapid revision course is really helpful in last days to minimize the course in little time.
Okay. So any subjects that you think will I mean, every doctor has some subjects which are good, I mean favorite, and some subjects which are like somebody's paranoid about or is nervous about. So which were your Harshit's subjects which Harshit was nervous, and which were like Harshit knew, oh, I know this, you know? So let's start with the ones you were nervous with.
I was nervous about medicine first of all because it's the major subject.
Okay.
But the medicine questions were really integrated and you can solve by the clinical concepts. Also, I was confused about microbiology, the agars and all stuff. Yeah, and more about. Let's say pharmacology, because in application I was really sure about pharmacology, like that I am going to make it. But while solving in the exam, I was afraid that what drug they are going to ask, like that. Yeah.
Okay. So any special feature of the PrepLadder app that you liked?
I like the question banks, and mainly especially the question bank 3.0, because in the previous question bank, question bank 2.0, the main thing was like, you need to read the whole question. In 3.0 also you need to read whole question, but after solving the MCQ, you will get the
highlights.
Highlighted part. Yeah, so the students, when solving the MCQ, they will know that you only need to focus on these things. If you know these things, keywords, key points, key features, so you just you know, bang on track.
Yes. It's great. Doc, my best wishes to you on an illustrious career ahead, and I would also like to I would say convey my regards to your parents for a great upbringing, for creating a doctor for our country, and do convey my regards to them as well. And you've done great, Doc, and I'm very sure that you'll be doing excellent in your future career ahead.
Thank you so much, Doc.
Thank you.
It's an honor to meet you, Doc.
Yes, same here for me as well.